I'll just move to where's the next section, which is how to set section styles for different objects or different layers in Rhino. And this is new to Rhino 8. And the goal is to get something like what is in the first picture here. So, but the question is in Rhino, how do you set that up? You can set it by object or by layer, and we will go through the both of them. And there are actually three different ways, as in the handout as well, that you will see is possible to set section styles. So setting section styles by layers. Let's go to the wall layer, and under section style, let me just move things a little bit here so they are within. So under the wall layer, there is a section style column. It might not be in the, yeah, I would, if you open the file that I gave you, it will be in that exact location, but sometimes it's maybe after the materials or the line type. But in Rhino 8, you can just move it closer if you will, or if you want, and if you're using it more often, you can just put it wherever you want that is convenient to you. All right, so I just move the section style a little closer so we can see it. Under walls, now it by default it is set to none. That means there is no hatch pattern associated with that layer, and all the objects in that layer that are set to be by layer, their section style. So if I click on the wall, and now the word none, I click on it, it opens a dialog box, which is the section style dialog box. It has two main sections. It has the hatch and the boundary settings for that particular section style. And under the hatch, you can select the pattern. Let's say we set it to hatch one. And let's say the pattern color be by object. Let's rotate it 45 degrees. Let's scale it by 5, for example. The background is the same as the viewport. I'll leave the boundary as is. And if I want to reset it to none, you just click none. But for now, I'll go OK. And see what happened. Because we have already clipped through that view, the hatch pattern now is showing. See the hatch pattern for the walls? And if I'm not happy with the spacing or the scale, obviously click on the custom again and change that from 5 to 6, for example, and press OK. And that will change the scale a little bit to whatever I like. We can repeat that with other layers, for example, the sand layer. Let's click on the sand layer and under section style, click on the none. It opens the section style dialog box. And I'm going to choose the new sand pattern that we have here. I'll just take my guess to keep it with the same rotation and the scale and see if that's good enough for me. Press OK. And that looks okay for me here. This is the part that has been sectioned, and the you can see the section style, the sand part here, and that layer already activated. Do the same thing under the earth. Go to none, click on it, and change it from none to earth. And I'll just change the direction to 45. Keep the scale 1 just to see if that's appropriate to scale. And maybe this is too dense for what I want. So I go back, click custom again, and change the scale to perhaps 3. And that's kind of looking a little more like what I wanted. So as you can see that now that we have set up all these layers to different section styles. Anytime a clipping a plane clips the view, that section style is going to show. If I click on the foundation object itself and go to the object property, you can see under section style here, it is set by layer. And this is what I want in this case. I want that object to follow whatever section style that layer is, which is the earth, right? But that might not be the case for every single object that I want, right? I might want certain objects in a layer to be with one section style, but or multiple section styles. Like, for example, in the case of foundation layer, it might have parts that are concrete, this one, for example, but the insulation in between the walls will want to set to a different hatch pattern. So in that case, I will actually change by object. I'll change the section style by object. So go to the foundation, I select the object itself, and then go to the object properties under section style. Instead of by layer, I will set it to be custom. And that opens the exact same dialog box. And you can see that that object is actually now set, already has been preset to the concrete, but wasn't showing because the visibility wasn't by object, it was by layer. And let me just use that. And if you don't have it set, you just go drop down, set it to concrete, and then let's keep the scale the same and see how that looks. Press OK. And as you can see, that object now shows that concrete hatch pattern. We can repeat the process for the insulation, select that box, insulation box, and instead of section style by layer, we set it to custom. And in this case, we're going to do a grid that is rotated 45 degrees and kept to that scale. And this, maybe I'll change the scale for it. So repeat the process and I'll change it to 4. And this is basically how you start to get different hatch patterns for objects that are clipped with the clipping a plane. But also in the next steps, when we actually start extracting drawings, it's going to take into account the hatch patterns that has been set for these objects.